Good Sunday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick check of your forecast. Again, decently quiet and getting much quieter into later on tonight. We're seeing an end of the rainfall in sight for now, but as we go into the next several days, we are going to be seeing the possibility of maybe some more flooding potential out there as we get some very heavy rainfall very close to the Mid-South area. Latest forecast, if you haven't tuned in since last night, we are looking again at more chances of rainfall heading on through, and that could really cause some problems as we get into the next couple of days, especially again anything around or close to rivers, lakes, creeks, and streams, things like that. So we could be seeing again some very soggy conditions out there for outdoor activities, and also again for the possibility of driving around the Mid-South area, not looking at great conditions for travel. We'll talk more about that. So far, no winter weather showing up at this time, so that's good news. And also again, not seeing too much in the way of severe weather, so also good news on that. But we'll take a look at that coming up here in just a little bit. Drop your location, and if you got any weather reports out there, we'd love to see more about what's going on wherever you happen to be, whether it's in the Mid-South area or points beyond. For those of you who have never tuned in here before, first of all, welcome to the show. This is, again, our nightly broadcast, or netcast, I guess I should say, again, to keep you updated as to what's going on. So if you got questions about the forecast for East Arkansas, North Mississippi, West Tennessee, and Shelby County and Memphis right there in the middle, all you have to do is just ask them, and I'll do what I can to answer what I can in the time that we have. If you can't stick around for the whole thing, forecast in the blue bar in this lower section in front of you, or you can go to, again, WREG.com/weather, and you get all the weather forecast information there, including our new Your Environment blog, which just posted tonight, so stick around for more on that. Currently, again, expecting for overnight some pretty chilly conditions. The clouds are going to be breaking up. We've got winds out of the west-northwest turning north overnight, and as the clouds break up, they act kind of like a blanket. Have you ever had the blanket yanked off of you in the middle of the night, and it gets cold very quickly because all that body heat dissipates? That's what's going to be happening tonight as we look into tomorrow morning. It clears out a little bit, just enough. Whatever heat we had from the day that could be kept in by that cloud cover is just going to radiate away. So tomorrow morning is going to be a lot colder than what we've seen for a while. Lower 30s, maybe even a few mid to upper 20s across portions of the area. So please keep that in mind if you're going to be outdoors and up and outdoors again for tomorrow morning. Could be some very chilly conditions out there. 38 in Bartlett. Paulette Anders, thank you very much for that weather report from there. Welcome to everybody else tuning in from across the area. Fane Crook, I think you win the farthest away award for right now. Key West, Florida, I bet it's a lot warmer there than it is here. Thank you for checking in from the farthest point south in the area in the United States, if I'm not mistaken. 41 in Huntington, Tennessee. Teresa Esther, thank you very much for checking in with that weather report there, and everybody else who's checking in for this evening. Got a lot of people into and around the area for right now. 4 to 5 inches of snow in lower Michigan, 28 degrees, William Skage. Thank you very much for that one. A lot of votes for no on the rainfall for tonight at this point in time. So we could be seeing, again, chances of rain, which could be a bit of a problem out there. A lot of no votes for that. Scott Bullard, concerned with mudslides and such. Well, the Mid-South doesn't really have the high hills that you see in like the Appalachians, East Tennessee, or the Rockies, but it is still going to be a problem with heavy rainfall coming on through. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Welcome to the show if you're just joining us, and thanks for stopping by Weather Overtime. Again, you can get more weather information again at WREG.com/weather. Chilly today. The cloud cover did a good job of blocking out the sunshine, so didn't make the 50s as we were expecting. Mid-50s is where we should be. 40 degrees, pretty close to the low temperature out there. 1/16 of an inch of rainfall, and we're still ahead for the year by almost 2 inches, so we're doing very good on precipitation for right now. Downtown Memphis, again, the clouds breaking up a little bit. Big River Crossing lit up quite nicely at this time, doing its nightly animation bit for right now, and pretty quiet in downtown Memphis. We're not seeing anything in the way of rainfall left over from this. Good news for travelers, the construction has wrapped up for the weekend. I-240 in all directions. Traffic is, again, heading on through there. So the construction at this time, this was the last scheduled construction from TDOT. So anything in the future is going to be having to be put on the calendar. We don't have it yet because they don't have it, but when TDOT does have that, if it happens, keep it tuned to News Channel 3 and we'll let you know. But either way, well ahead of schedule. So thanks to all the TDOT workers out there. Stay safe and thank you very much for getting our infrastructure safer and making certain that things are much better there. And again, that area from around 240, that's where it was closed down. Everything open on the east side of the loop for right now. So good news there. Showers left over into and around the area, heading into around northeast Mississippi, and as of right now, that we're going to be seeing again the possibility of those showers leaving the area as we get into later on tonight. Again, chances of rainfall early on from east of Oxford, right around Corinth, Tupelo, all that moving on out of the picture. So we're done with the rainfall for now, but it's not going to be sticking around again the drier weather for a while. Anyway, Joe Selmansberger, what can we do to stop these dreaded man-made temperatures in the 60s? That we've been suffering through lately? Well, when it comes to climate change, we all can pitch in and do a better job on a lot of different things. If you want to check out some of that, head to my Facebook page and my other social media accounts. You can find out a lot more about why we need to protect the environment and ways that we can do that. So good question. Thank you for asking that one for right now. Marta Rust Hartzog, is all of this rain normal for the area? We've been getting a little bit more for this time of the year, but usually and typically November is our rainiest month for this area of the country. February is up there, but we don't pick up, again, quite as much as we do in November, so we can get a decent amount, but not seeing a lot of that in the way of record amounts, at least for right now. Over normal, yes, but not record anyway. Now, currently, we're not seeing anything really starting to replace this at this point in time. As we look back toward the west, we see again a decent storm system back over parts of the Intermountain West here. Not what we're going to be seeing in the near future. What we're actually going to be seeing is an area of low pressure developing down here in the Gulf of Mexico. That's going to shovel a ton of moisture up here. We also have an atmospheric river coming in from off the Pacific. That's helping to push some of these clouds over portions of the area here, but most of our rainfall at this time is making its way up from the Gulf of Mexico, and that's going to be significant as we go into the next several days with chances of rainfall starting to stack up out there. Temperatures this evening on WeatherNet 3 back in the upper 30s to lower 40s. Winds have switched around to the north-northwest, so a little breezy, a little drier air coming on through, so less rainfall, less clouds, and that's going to make it decently chilly into and around tomorrow morning. Heather Hubbard, 37 degrees, partly cloudy in Blytheville. Thank you very much for that one. Trey Harris, 40 degrees in Gleason, Tennessee. Thank you very much for that one. 41 in Batesville. Billy Lightning, welcome back to the show. Thank you very much. My yard already feels like a sponge. Yeah, my backyard is a little squishy too at this point in time. Antonio Thompson Sr., keep an umbrella handy. Very good idea. Thank you very much for that one. Jason Peacock, March and April. They can be a decent amount of rainfall, kind of a wet month out there before we get into the dry season of summer between about roughly May and into even late October. It can be pretty dry out there for about half of the year. So, yeah, as far as I know, yes, that can be, again, the potential for some heavier rainfall out there. Richard Pepper, is it going to rain all week? We'll answer that question in just a little bit. Cyrita Flournoy, hope I'm saying that correctly. When are we going to warm up? We'll have more on the seven-day forecast here for you in just a little bit. Through News Channel 3 at 10, again, some sporadic showers out there, but that's going to be about it. And that dry air comes in, clears us out, removes the cloud cover, and then the heat from today radiates upwards. So we could see some upper 20s and some lower 30s into tomorrow morning. A lot of you have the day off tomorrow, so staying in on a chilly morning, definitely going to need a hot beverage tomorrow morning. We'll see if we can get the cough temp decks working in the next couple of days here for you. Temperatures remain a little bit on the chilly side as we go into and around the area of tomorrow morning, about mid-morning or so. Clouds will be sticking around. They're not going to be gone, but they will break up a little bit through the day tomorrow, so we will see at least a little bit of sunshine, but not enough for the temperatures. We'll be back in the mid-40s, those northerly winds, a little bit more cloud cover out there. That's going to drop the temperatures again to just below normal. So we will see some chillier conditions out across the area, but we are going to be getting, again, at least a little bit of a break from the rainfall, and this will be one of the only days we get rain-free for pretty much almost the rest of the month. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little bit. Austen Onek, hope I'm saying that right, 40 degrees in Dyersburg. Just down the road, Ripley, Tennessee. Elvis Etheridge, 38 degrees. Thank you very much for that weather report. John M. Hill, Do we need our life jackets next week? No, but I hear Home Depot is having a sale on gopher wood, so that might come in pretty handy at this point. Thank you very much for asking, and everybody else who's checking in at this time. Rest of the week, again, looking at the potential of severe weather, not for tonight, and again, good news, not for tomorrow. Now, there could be, again, a few thunderstorms down to our south, just generic thunderstorms, not seeing anything in the way of severe weather. Now, as we go into and around the area of Tuesday, that's where we could see, just south of the News Channel 3 viewing area, at least a marginal threat for severe weather. And again, that's down south of Batesville, down toward Jackson, and all the way down into and around portions of just north and west of New Orleans. So not a huge thing, but something to keep an eye on, and that's what we'll be doing here, so stick around for more on that. Here's the big weather story, and this is what we're going to be seeing over the next several days, to where we get some very heavy amounts of rainfall. Now this, again, these model numbers fluctuate all the time. These numbers will probably be different by the time the next model run comes out about midnight and again about 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. But here's what we're looking at for right now. Northeast Arkansas, decent amount of rainfall, but not, again, anything in the way of major amounts of problem rainfall. Memphis and West Tennessee right here, North Mississippi, East Arkansas for benchmark purposes, Mississippi River running on down through here. From the Mississippi River through the Tennessee into Middle Tennessee, North Alabama, and Northern Georgia, East Tennessee could be winding up with 4 to 8 inches of rainfall. Heaviest is going to be between, say, Atlanta and back towards Chattanooga. So we're not going to be seeing a lot out of the really heavy stuff. But if this, over the next few days, drifts just a little bit, all that rainfall has got to go someplace. So we could be seeing, again, some very heavy rainfall out there in the next couple of days. The ground at this time, over the last several days, has already got a bunch of rainfall. So there's already a lot of water in the soil. If the water was dry, the rainfall would fall on the soil would drink it in, and it would absorb all that. In this case, the water molecules are up all the way to the surface, so the rain falls down, runs off into the culverts, the ditches, the streams, the rivers, things like that, and they rise very rapidly. So that's where the flooding potential is coming from over the next several days. So what we're looking for right now is going to be, again, that potential for the heaviest rainfall starting late Monday into early Tuesday, and continuing into around at least Thursday into Friday from what it looks like. So some pretty soggy days ahead for right now. Shanice Perry Royston, no rain for tomorrow. Looks pretty dry at this point for tomorrow, but late Monday, that's where we could see, again, some more rainfall out there. John Moore, why are we getting so much rainfall? This is the way the situation stacks up, to where we have an area of low pressure down to the Gulf of Mexico. That rotates counterclockwise, and that motion in the atmosphere acts like a giant conveyor belt to move all that moisture-rich air up off the Gulf of Mexico and deposit it right there. So again, if that area of low pressure had formed, say, over toward Florida, then all of this would be over several hundred miles and would not be a threat to any part of the southeast United States, except for maybe the coastal areas. Right now, the area of low pressure is doing a good job of shoveling all that moisture-rich air up our direction. So we could see, again, some very heavy rainfall over the next couple of days. If you have any drains or culverts near your house, the storm drain gates, if that has junk in it or debris or yard waste, branches and stuff like that out of that, get that stuff out of there. It's partly your responsibility because you live in that area, and again, it's something that everybody wants to think, oh, it's somebody else's problem. Well, if you take care of that now, in the next couple of days, you're not going to have to worry about that, so that might help everybody without anything backing up in the way of moisture to the point of causing flooding in a neighborhood where it gets a couple of feet deep. You could have cleaned that out from beforehand, so if you got that going on, if you see a drain in your neighborhood that's blocked at the storm grate area, clean that out. The water can then at least run through very easily as it drains away from your area and heads out of the picture. This could be, again, some serious situations, again, with flooding, covering over roadways, if we get that much and if we get enough in a very short amount of time. Remember, turn around, don't drown. never drive through water-covered roadways. It's one of the worst things you can possibly do. It takes about 6 inches to 1 foot of rushing water to sweep a car right off the roadway. And yes, that includes things like large vans, SUVs, things like that. That water has an amazing amount of force when it's moving, and it doesn't take much to get that vehicle floating off the roadway, and that mistake could be your last. So please remember that in the next several days. We'll keep you updated on this as we see again that potential for rainfall heading on through. Now, drier weather tomorrow at this point in time. Jontavious Evans, what's up with the forecast? Well, we'll tell you that coming up here in just a little bit. Thanks for dropping on by for that. Checking in on some fog tomorrow morning. We'll be looking again at the potential for drier weather. So we're not seeing that much in the way of a problem with fog. We had a lot of it around the area this morning, but we're just not seeing too much of anything in the way at this point in time. Tim Gautreaux, hope I'm saying that right. Michigan snowing a lot. Yeah, the winter weather up that direction doing a very good job of causing some major traffic backups on I-70. And if you'd like to see some of that video from Weather Nation, head to my Facebook page and you can see some of those 30, 40, 50 car pileups up that direction. So some pretty nasty travel conditions up that direction there. Now tomorrow, again, mostly cloudy, a little bit on the cool side. Temperatures back in the mid to upper 40s for the holiday itself. Heading into Tuesday, kids heading back to school, you heading to work, allow for some extra time to get to where you're going because you're going to need it. Rushing around on wet roadways with low visibility is not a good idea. So get the rain gear ready to go for the kids who have to walk or bike ride to school on Tuesday morning. They will need that rain protection going to school and coming back home again. So a soggy day coming up on Tuesday. Likewise on Wednesday, showers throughout the entire day, pretty much run over with rainfall this time with about 100% chance throughout the entire day. Now we get a bit of a gap in the rainfall Wednesday night into Thursday, and then after that it starts to pick back up again as we go into the weekend, including some very warm temperatures back in the upper 60s by the time we work our way into and around the weekend hours of next week. Doesn't look like severe weather. The extended forecast doesn't hold anything up there in the way of stronger weather coming on through. I would watch this very carefully. And again, the potential for stronger weather close to the Mid-South on Tuesday is something we're all going to need to pay attention to for right now. So this is what we're looking at for the time being for the next 7 days. Here's the good news, and yes, there is some. So again, thanks for sticking around for that much anyway. We're seeing again as we go toward the last few days of February, finally getting a chance to ring out. So as we get toward about the last few days of the month, temperatures quite pleasant. Numbers over the next several days, very nice. No major winter weather, no cold snap, no Arctic blast, no polar vortex coming on through, and some very mild temperatures overall, and not seeing that much in the way of chilly numbers. No snow, no ice, anything like that coming our way. So very quiet for right now. But again, as we go toward next week, not this week, but the week after, we're starting to see some drying conditions out there. All we have to do is get through this mess, and it looks like things are going to be much better for us in the course of the next couple of days. Maybe you just moved to the area. You've never dealt with severe weather before. You've never gone through a tornado warning before. This is going to be one of the best places you can go to learn about severe weather. It's called Skywarn. It's volunteer groups of storm spotters watching what goes on. Not chase groups, that's something entirely different, and you do not chase storms unless you have been trained by experts, period, end of sentence. Don't argue with me on this, okay? It's a very safe thing to do. It's, again, as long as you keep your distance from the storms, what the National Weather Service needs, we've got tons of great technology, but what we need is you looking, listening, and calling that information back to the National Weather Service so they can tell everybody else what's going on. These meetings last about an hour, hour and a half. They're totally free, paid for by your tax dollars and my tax dollars. So it's one of the best ways, in my not so humble opinion, that our tax dollars have been spent. And if you'd like to see more about this and the first few meetings, the first two will be coming up this week, Tuesday the 19th, one in Senatobia, one in Boonville. Next one will be the Thursday of this week in Henning, Tennessee. And then on the next Monday, Pontotoc, Mississippi, that'll be at 6:30 p.m. How do you know more? Where's the addresses for these things? Who do you contact for more details? What can you expect to learn in these classes when you take them? Who's teaching them? meteorologist from the National Weather Service in Memphis. And if you'd like to know more, weather.gov and then /MEG, that's the three-letter designator for the National Weather Service. But if you can't remember that right there, go to weather.gov, click on the Mid-South area. It'll take you to the National Weather Service in Memphis, and then you can click on the Skywarn training session information. Please consider doing this. The more people we have trained in the Mid-South, the more we will be protected from severe weather by being able to watch what goes on. Again, it's a great opportunity to learn more. I've seen kids as young as 8 or 9 years old take these meetings. It gives kids a little bit more control over what they might think to be kind of an uncontrollable situation. Severe weather can be scary to a lot of people, and this class can help you kind of grab a hold of that fear and get more information. Knowledge is your best weapon in situations like this. So please consider becoming a spotter. We need your help. Please consider that over the next few days. All right, with the loss of the Opportunity rover, Curiosity is in Gale Crater on Mars and still reporting back weather information. High temperature of 1 degree above zero. A low temperature last week Wednesday of 97 degrees below zero. And some pretty good amounts of ultraviolet light going on out there. If you'd like to pick up this weather information from the next planet over, all you have to do is go to mars.nasa.gov for the Remote Environmental Monitoring Station. Very cool to see this. Again, it's called Exometeorology, Weather on Other Planets. Really neat to kind of see that in motion for right there. My forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. New Your Environment blog dropped tonight. If you'd like to know more about that, wreg.com/weather/environment. It's all listed there at the top of the screen. Chilly start to tomorrow morning, and again, some sunshine mixed in with the clouds. It's going to take a while to warm up, though. Temperatures by tomorrow will only be back into the mid-30s by about mid-morning, so pretty chilly out there for right now. Quick check of what we're going to be taking a look at in my weathercast coming up on my Facebook page. We call it, Weather Where the Troops Are. If you'd like to know more about this and maybe take a look around the world and see what it's like at places like Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam in Hawaii with rain and temperatures a little cooler back in the lower 70s. That's a far cry from northern Greenland where, again, we had a wind chill of about, well, looks like it's not showing up right now, but a temperature of about minus 22 last hour in northwestern areas of Greenland. So if you'd like to see more about this, please join me on my Facebook page coming up in a little less than half an hour. That's at facebook.com/AustenOnek WREG for more. I'll have updates on your weathercast tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, so please make certain you stay tuned for more information on that. We'll have, again, updates on what's going on there. Plus, if you're up early tomorrow morning, even though it's President's Day, you may want to check out weather and traffic. Please make certain you stay tuned for Todd Demers' forecast, and Corey Ventura should be on with more on News Channel 3 Time Saver Traffic as well. More information, questions, concerns, complaints, if you absolutely must, email me at austen.onek@wreg.com. Great to have you along for tonight. And again, thanks for stopping by and watching for at least a little bit on here and asking the questions and, of course, your, again, updates of weather where you are at this point in time. Thanks for more on that. Again, stick around for the detailed forecast coming up on News Channel 3 at 10 and, of course, on my Facebook page right before 9 o'clock. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for much more with News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend. Todd Demers has more on your forecast coming up bright and early on Monday morning. Thanks for watching tonight.